Thank you for joining us here on The Web. A Massachusetts teen allegedly involved in a deadly accident remains free on bail. Michael Ricci is accused of causing the crash last month on I-95 that killed an off-duty officer. Ricci was scheduled to be in court today for a hearing on where his bail money came from, but that was canceled. WMUR's Ray Brewer explains what's next.
Michael Ricci has yet to appear in a New Hampshire courtroom. Now it looks like the earliest that'll happen will be January of next year.
I wouldn't say that we're frustrated at this point. We are still working on the case actively, so the fact that he hasn't gone yet before the judge really doesn't make a difference to our case and how we're looking at the strength of it.
Back on October 8th, police say that Michael Ricci made an illegal U-turn on I-95. Ricci subsequently hit a motorcycle whose rider, an off-duty Somerville, Massachusetts police officer, would later die of his injuries. Several other vehicles were also involved.
The police are still working on their investigation. We look forward to getting their full reports, and we'll continue to work on the case once we receive those.
Ricci is currently charged with negligent homicide, 4 counts of reckless conduct, and second-degree assault. However, there is the possibility that more charges could be added.
Once we see the full reports, we'll review those and make whatever charging decisions we might need to make based upon what we see.
As of right now, the next hearing date is January 3rd. That hearing is for a dispositional conference.
That's a time when the attorneys talk with the judge, let the judge know what the status of the case is.
As for the possibility of any plea bargain, the deputy county attorney says it's far too soon in the process to consider that. In Brentwood, Ray Brewer, WMUR News 9.
Right now, FEMA teams are touring the state to get a firsthand look at the storm damage. If a federal disaster is declared, there would be money available to help fix damaged infrastructure like roads and bridges. But first, officials have to confirm that there is at least $2 million in damage. More than 100 people are still without power. Any home or business owners with property damage are being urged to call 211. And happening today, voters in 11 cities are heading to the polls. 10 cities will elect mayors, including Manchester, where incumbent mayor Ted Gatsis is once again facing off against challenger Joyce Craig. Voters in Manchester will also be asked if the Queen City should change its flag. The current flag features the city seal. You can see it right there in the upper left corner. The other 3 are the proposed redesigns. And residents in 10 cities will also decide whether to approve Keno. The lottery game has already been approved at the state level to help pay for all-day kindergarten. But local communities have to vote on it themselves. There are also a variety of city, school board, and ward positions up for grabs today. A local group is asking for help as it tries to figure out the best way to prepare high school students for the future. Reaching Higher New Hampshire interviewed more than 250 Granite State students, asking them what learning opportunities they feel give them a better advantage when applying to colleges or jobs after high school. The Ready in the 603 series features 4 videos. Granite Staters are now being encouraged to vote for the one they find most compelling. The voting closes on Monday. And starting tonight at 5, one New England town making history on this election day, choosing a mayor for the first time. And a new look at the potential link between drinking alcohol and developing cancer. That does it for us. Have a great afternoon.